Doug Kalitta is Top Fuel Drag Racing's Clark Kent. Right, well, he is the guy that walking down the street looks like any normal Joe, and he sits in that race car, and we have seen him do really exceptional things over the years. Some of the greatest pedal jobs you've ever seen. The guy's taking one of these cars to the finish line with the tires hazing smoke like it's 1965. The guy just drove the car with a blown up tire at 332 miles an hour, and he is not the type of guy to scream and yell about it or even say boo.
It's crazy, you know. You'd think the way that he drives that he'd be a guy that's kind of amped up and ready to go all the time, but he just calm, cool, doesn't matter if it's final round or qualifying round. Like, he has the same demeanor, but once he gets in the car, it's like he's ready to rip your head off. And that's kind of the mentality that you need to have to be successful and to be competitive out here.
He knows this much. He knows where the pedal is. And he's got excellent eyesight because he knows where the tree is.
I've had the fortune to work with some really good drivers over the years. And Doug is at this stage in his life, obviously, he's one of the best drivers out here. His experience level is high. He can, drive with the best of them. And I think a lot of that comes with motivation to win.
In my position, I can't root for anybody, but I can identify a damn good story when I see it. And Doug Kalitta is a damn good story.
Just reeling off two consecutive races, just in the amount of time when it counts the most, the countdown to the championship, going to Reading, Pennsylvania, running quick, running the table, and of course, just 1 week ago, beating one of the quickest cars to the eighth mile, and that was Mike Salinas. Doug Kalitta did his business in this final round.
If I win this year,
we should try. I might as well, right?
I hear you, buddy. I hear you.
All right. Nice one. Nice night, Doug.
All right, brother. Thanks. Thank you.
Here, buddy. Get
it, Doug. Hope the track ain't too hot today.
Yeah, it'll probably be like this tomorrow, too. So we're going to figure it out today, hopefully.
Yeah, these guys are better with all that technology. Aren't
they? Yeah, that's the old guy. Not so good.
Yeah, that's so good. Thank you. Appreciate it. Good luck, Ray.
Thanks.
Yeah, I just always say we got two down, four to go. So far, we've started off our qualifying pretty well. Last night was probably the best conditions for what we're doing out here. So that was a big round for us to get down the track, and fortunately we did.
And it doesn't look like they missed it again. Doug Kalitta, 3.709, right to the top of the qualifying sheet at 331.85 miles an hour. Do it once and it gets our attention. Do it twice, we think you're pretty good. Do it three times and now we're locked in.
Well, something's working for sure. In the last two races, has there been anything that just kind of clicked for you, or is it just,
Yeah, for me, it's, the guys in the lounge up there that are tuning my car and the consistency that we got going on has been the key to it, really. So,
well, cool. Well, good luck tomorrow and today and everything. And thank you so much for talking to me. And I really wish you the best.
Okay. Have a good day. Appreciate it.
Thanks. Check
mine out. Okay. Did you get one of these already?
I turned you down last time, but I'm going to take one anyway. Right.
I got one. Yeah,
I
got one.
Yeah, how are you doing? To see what how the car will run, with the setup that Alan and Brian are going to put at it. So
It seems pretty warm. Just talking to Nick there, he's it's definitely pretty warm, so the track ought to be a little greasy. So, but that's what really all today's all about. It's just trying to figure out a good setup for tomorrow. Dream come true to have these guys, you know, tune my car and have it running like it is. So, so yeah, we're just all real hungry as a team, and you know, a big old team effort going on here. So, you know, we're just real thankful, you know, for what we've done the last couple races, and just want to keep it going.
Doug Kalitta pulls the tire loose out there at about 300 feet. Tony Schumacher shortly after that drops the flames. So Antron Brown is going to pick up some points for that 381. Low ET of the session. But Doug Kalitta is going to stay in the number one spot.
It's great having Doug as a teammate. Doug's a wealth of knowledge. Doug's a veteran of the sport. He's been through a lot. And, you know, there's a lot of things that will, ideas or stuff with the track or whatever that we can bounce off of one another. But a lot of times when you're talking with Doug, you do a lot of listening, because if you're listening, then you're learning.
He's a pretty quiet person, so it's hard to judge his emotions sometimes. But you can, I'm learning it. You can see him get excited now. And but he's just laid back guy. He's fun to be around, and he's very he's a good cheerleader. I mean, he's good for keeping everybody's spirits up, and he always congratulates everybody, tells him good job, and I appreciate that from him.
You know, Doug was somebody that I looked up to when I first started driving Top Fuel. I remember, you know, driving the Skull Shine car 2006, 2007. Dougie was always in the middle of the championship hunt with Tony Schumacher back then. Just, I always considered him one of the best Top Fuel drivers out there. And to this day, I still believe that. And to have him as a teammate now, just, he hasn't changed a bit. He's just so calm, cool. He kind of has the nickname the Iceman for a reason.
.372, 330 miles an hour. Give Doug Kalitta three more points as he knocks down his 53rd number one qualifying spot.
72, you're low and number one.
I really think it's what we would go for.
Good run, man.
Go, Doug.
All right, I got Doug whenever we're ready.
Doug Kalitta has been saying the word consistency a lot, and boy, has he been consistent. Number one qualifier, you got three little points for being low of the session, and this car has been on rails. How are you guys doing this?
Yeah, no, it's we're super happy to have this yellow hat on. So, yeah, just a hell of a team effort with Alan and Brian and this whole Mack Tools Toyota team. We're in RevChem. I mean, they're just, everybody's working their tails off on this car, and it's really starting to show. So we're one of my favorite places, St. Louis. So we're just hoping to have a, you know, just go rounds tomorrow and have some fun.
Qualified number one with his Friday run of 3.709 at 331 miles an hour. Second number one this season, 53rd in his career. Obviously last night was great, but to close out qualifying with a run like that, how big was that for you guys heading into race day?
Yeah, with Salinas in front of us, and you never can tell. You know, they're always capable of throwing out a big number, but they smoked the tires. So, but no, I was real happy, definitely with that 72 in that last session. You know, my car's been real consistent. So, yeah, just can't say enough about Alan and Brian, and really how hard everybody's working on this, on my car here. So, you know, great crowd here today, obviously, with sounded like Ryan was saying it was a sellout. So that's congrats to all you guys for what you do here. So, but it's probably going to be warm like it was yesterday, or today, tomorrow. So we're looking forward to it for sure.
These last year and three quarters, 2 years, whatever, you know, it's been a journey to get to this point. How impressed have you been, have you been with just the way this team has kind of stuck together and pushed forward and kept working hard to kind of get to this point where you're at now?
Yeah, I just didn't want to be a driver that didn't get a win with Alan Johnson. After like a year, I'm like, oh my God, this would not look good on your resume, right? But I love doing this. I'm normally pretty patient, but so you just got to hang in there. You know, you see the effort that's going into what's going on. I mean, Chad Head is. He's the reason that Alan is at with my team here. He's pretty much made it happen. Somehow convinced him, a couple years ago, whatever it was. But hats off to really what we're trying to do, and we'll see what we can do tomorrow.
Thanks a lot, Doug. Good luck tomorrow.
Yeah, it's been pretty impressive here with the last. This year in particular, just watching the car and everything kind of come together, all their ideas and then obviously working with my guys on this, on all the parts on this engine and just consistency of them putting it together correctly each time. And, it's the details of what's going on out there is, pretty solid right now. So really happy with how everybody's gelling, and we're just definitely hungry, like I say, and hoping for a good day. Any race day, just hope for a good one for sure. Yeah, it's all about everybody that's helped me get here, and obviously we got some work to do, and looking forward to the opportunity and the challenge of doing it. So, I've had such great support. Connie obviously has been. Owning these cars, my car, my whole career out here, so just a lot of people to be thankful to have, that worked hard to get me here.